Up next, the city is proposing adjustments to water and sewer rates. It's an important investment that needs to be made now to deal with aging infrastructure and future growth.
The city's infrastructure includes water, sewer treatment, as well as our water system. And it's important to the city because it really is the foundation for how we grow as a city.
That includes water treatment and the water lines to convey and distribute water and treat it. Also the wastewater treatment plant. That is a very important piece of infrastructure because you need to treat the wastewater before we discharge it to the environment. And also the collection system, those series of pipes in the city that bring the wastewater to the treatment plant, critical infrastructure.
Well, the funding for infrastructure comes from two primary sources. One are our rates that we charge our users. The other is system development charges. Those are the charges that we impose on new development to pay for growth. With our current system, we have quite a few existing deficiencies. Those deficiencies need to be corrected by using ratepayer dollars, and those include aging infrastructure. We have federal mandates that we need to comply with, as well as just modernizing our system.
We have a number of infrastructure needs, particularly in the water department, where the federal government is going to require us to start filtering our water or treating it with UV to kill cryptosporidium, which is something we've never had in our water.
Even though our water sources show no contamination, we still have to treat it to federal standards. We are one of a handful of communities here in Oregon that do not filter their water. However, it was made clear in 1992 that by 2012, we would have to filter our water regardless.
Secondly, we've got an aging transmission lines that take the water, our surface water, from Tumalo Falls into the city.
Well, parts of the insides of that pipe are showing up in our holding tanks. And so what that's telling us is that that 80-year-old pipe is failing. Now, while the county and the Forest Service are digging up the road to replace the road out to Tumalo Falls, we can put new pipe under that road and improve that infrastructure for the next 80 years.
The city of Bend, like many other cities, their infrastructure was put in at the turn of the century. So we've got infrastructure that's aging that needs to be repaired. And if we don't repair it, it could mean a potential major liability for the city.
We need these rate increases for a number of reasons. One, we have unfunded mandates that we're under to meet in the future, being water treatment. Two, we have a wastewater treatment facility that is at capacity in its design life and needs to be upgraded.
And it was built with growth in mind, but not the staggering growth that we felt in our community. So now we're approaching the capacity of that facility, so we need to expand it. If we don't expand it, we're going to start having to turn away business.
One of the things that I'm really focused on right now is making sure that we've got shovel-ready employment land, land that we can offer to large employers in this town. That's something that we're missing. And we're not going to be able to do that if we don't have infrastructure to support that.
So funding it is one of the issues. One area we're looking at is rate increases for both water and sewer. I think we would still be one of the lowest priced cities for water and wastewater in Oregon, but it can be substantial increases, and in today's environment economically, we really don't want to do those increases. So we're looking everywhere we can. Are there grants? Are there other options that we can come up with money? But I think part of it is going to have to be funded by ratepayers.
We need to put ourselves in a position to raise those rates here locally in order to position ourselves to apply for grants at the federal and state level.
By doing that, it opens up the opportunities for grants in the future. By having a decent rate, the federal government, the state government, knows that you're maintaining that infrastructure, and therefore you can be eligible for grants.